أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على رسول الله محمد الصادق الأمين. Welcome, dear brothers and sisters, in our weekly tafsir class. We are on page 565, سورة القلم. Allow me to recite the page, inshallah ta'ala. Then we'll go over the general meanings, inshallah ta'ala. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna balawnahum kama balawna ashabal jannah إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون فطاف عليها طائف من ربك وهم نائمون فأصبحت كالصريم فتنادوا مصبحين أن اغدوا على حرثكم إن كنتم صارمين فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين وغدوا على حرد قادرين فلما رأوها قالوا إنا لضالون بل نحن محرومون قال أوسطهم ألم أقل لكم لولا تسبحون قالوا سبحان ربنا إنا كنا ظالمين فأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتلاومون قالوا يا ويلنا إنا كنا طاغين عسى ربنا أن يبدلنا خيرا منها إنا إلى ربنا راغبون كذلك العذاب ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون صدق الله العظيم إنا بلوناهم إنا This is the pronoun for the speaker. As you remember, in Arabic, we have three types of pronouns. The pronouns for the speaker, أنا or نحن. The pronouns for the listener, أنت, أنت, أنتما, أنتم, أنتن. And we have the pronouns for the absence, the third person, هو, هي, هما, هم, هن. So إنا, Allah is the speaker سبحانه وتعالى. And إنا here refers to the plural of respect, جمع التفخيم. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى speaks about himself as the only one who deserves to be worshipped, he will come up with the pronoun for single. إني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا. When he speaks about himself سبحانه وتعالى as a giver, as the one who has the blessing, he will come up with the plural of respect, the royal na, the royal we. إنا بلوناهم. البلاء is the test. And البلاء sometimes will be in a good thing, in a blessing, in giving, and sometimes in a negative thing, in taking, not giving, in put you under, for example, sickness, you will have disease, you will lose lives or lose rizq or lose security. Our brothers now in Palestine, in Sudan, in Iraq, in Syria, this all ibtila and bala. What is the wisdom behind the ibtila and the bala from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah Azza wa Jal is flipping you between health and sickness, between to have wealth or not to be a wealthy, to have sometimes problem, to lose lives and security. The Prophet, peace be upon him, he said, I'm wondering to the status of the believer. All his amr for him is good and is khair for him. In asabathu sarra, if he had a blessing, he will return it to Allah shukr, and this is good for him. And if he had hardship or problem, he will return it to Allah patience and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also this is good for him. And he said in the end of the hadith, nobody will achieve that kind of level of shukr and sabr except the mu'min, not the Muslim, the mu'min, the one that the iman is very strong in his heart. He has a foundation of trust and belief, and he understands the philosophy of his existence in this life. بَلَوْنَاهُمْ هُمْ, this pronoun refers to Meccan community. What kind of test Allah put Meccan community in? A lot of exams, a lot of tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes, like what happened, for example, in the history of the humanity, poverty, it's a big test. The lack of rain, it's a big test. The lack of business, when a city like Mecca, they depend on business to live, to survive. Like what happened in 2020, when the coronavirus hit this global, and you remember how the business used to be. It's a big test, a big ibtila, big exam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his servants, how they will react to his ibtila. Inna balawnahum means the Meccan community, as the story of the owners of the garden, Ashab al-Jannah. Al-Jannah, garden. And when you want to describe the garden, that it's very green, huge, full of fruits, water resources, water fall and lakes, beauty, luxury, it's like a Jannah. Any giving from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sometimes time to be tested in this blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each Muslim, he has to prepare himself to have the test. We don't ask Allah to test us. We don't ask Allah the ibtila, but we have to be prepared for the ibtila. Because we have been told in the Quran, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ أَحَسِبَ النَّاسِ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. You think, O mankind, that you will live in this life without having a test? No, you will have a test. We did that with the previous people, and we'll do it with you, and we will do it with the people that they will come after you. So if you have no exams, no hardship in your life, this is not a good sign. Be prepared for the exam. To know how to handle it, with patience, with trust. And the only dangerous thing, Ikhwani, what's going on with the people when they have tests from Allah, especially if it's a hard test, some of them, they flip. Nakasa ala aqibay means he flipped against Allah Azza wa Jalla. Instead of working hard to handle it and to minimize the impact, some of the humans, they flip against Allah and they start accusing him, why me? Why you picked me? What I did to you? I used to worship you. Now you are putting me in a test. And he will sometimes leave. Ashab al-Jannah, the people that they have garden. The father, before he passed away, he used to give from the blessing that he had from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the poor, to the neighbors, to the relatives, to the friends. He used to be a giver. He used to donate. And this is how the Muslims should be. The money that it's in your hand, it's not yours, by the way. It's just in your hand, but it's belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you hold, when you are not giving the right that Allah mentioned in the Quran. وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ مَعْلُومٌ. There is in my money right for others. There is a percentage of my money. It's just in my hand temporary. It's not mine. It's the right of others. The right of the fuqara, the right of masakin, the right of the orphans, the right of the needy, the right of the new Muslims. It's not mine. And this percentage is 2.5% yearly from whatever left in my hand in my remarkable day in my year, which is al-zakah farida. So don't hold that part. If you hold that 2.5% of what you have as if you steal it, and this is a crime, this is a sin. Ashabul Jannah, the kids of that good person, after he passed away, they decide not to give anybody, and they want to go to collect everything and sell it. And they said, let's go early before they arrive so we can tell them we don't have anything left. We sold everything. Their intention is loving the dunya. Their intention is why we should give them while they have time and opportunity to go and work, to go and build. That's, ikhwani, the whispering from Iblis. Why I should help? Because you are a mu'min, you are a Muslim, and your Lord, the one who created you, he is over you, commanding you to test you to see how you react in the blessing that you have. He told you to give. We obey our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying sami'na wa ata'na. Those kids, they were together and they decide together not to give in that year. And sometimes because Allah loves you, he will immediately give you the alert. Khwani, when you receive an alert from Allah, this is a sign of love, by the way. The musibah, if you will never receive an alert. The musibah, if you will be sinking in the sin years after years without any alert. Let me say it in a different way. From the signs of love from Allah to you, to give you an alert. Hey, wake up, you did something wrong. Sometimes, Ya Aba Khalid, this alert will come to you by being a failure in your project, for example. You intend and attempt to do something and it will not be completed. Or you will lose, or you will be sick. We ask Allah not to be in a test, but this is good sometimes. It's an alert for you to wake up and to review your position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why al-mu'min always, he will see what's behind, not just the surface, what's behind the scene. And immediately he will return to Allah. Ya Rabbi, I got the message. Ya Rabbi, thank you for waking me up. Ya Rabbi, thank you that you allow me to see it differently. This is a big ni'mah. For those kids, they said, إِذْ أَقْسَمُوا. Al-qasam means the oath. So they did an oath. We will go tomorrow early in the morning, take the positions, lock the doors, finish everything before the poor and the needy, as they used to do in the past, arrive and ask for their shares according to the experience with our father. So, إِذْ أَقْسَمُوا لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا. يَصْرِمُنَّهَا, cut the fruit. In Arabic, الصر, when you collect something and you make it close to your body. People used to put the money in a piece of fabric and they tied it and they put it under the belt. And they call this surra, surratul mal. Or they used to put it under the mattress or in any place in the house, surra. Yasrimunnaha means to collect and to hide. Musbihin, in the morning time. So their intention to go collect all the fruit and the vegetables, whatever they planted in the garden in the morning, tie it up, package it, ship it, and sell it. You can just imagine how they used to do before the needy and the poor arrive to ask for their shares according to the habit. Musbihin, this is a beautiful new vocabulary, means in the morning. La yasrimunnaha musbihin. Inna balawnahum. Naam. Tafaddal Hamza.
Yeah, jazakallah khair. Inshallah.
So, barakallah.
Can you repeat that again, what you just said?
حاضر حاضر إن شاء الله دكتور طيبة. البلاء it's a sunnah in this life. البلاء it's coming for each human in this dunya. Allah عز وجل he did ابتلاء for the believers and for the non-believers as what he is talking to us about the community of Mecca. إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا. I can call losing some money بلاء, and each one his بلاء will be according to his relationship with Allah. The more you have relationship with Allah, the more your بلاء will be. That's why the hadith sister Tayyiba, أشد الناس بلوى الأنبياء. The more people they have very severe ابتلاء are the messengers. Then ثم الذين يلونهم, then the people that are lower level than the انبياء, then the lowest level, etc. etc. بلاء could be light, could be heavy. If the بلاء is heavy, it could be fitna. That's why it's not a sign of love or hate when you have fitna or bala. The policy of this dunya that you will have bala. So we have to be prepared for the bala. And the bala, not just in the negative thing. If you are wealthy, this is bala. And you have the fitna in your money. Sometimes according to your reaction of the money that you have, what you are doing in your money, what you are doing in your ilm, what you are doing in your authority, what you are doing in your relationship, it's all bala and fitna, and your react will decide. I will give you an idea if you are passing or you are not passing the test. And as I said, Allah loves you. That's why He is flipping you between to be poor or rich, between to be in a hardship or in an easy, to pull the best of you, to pull the best of you. That's why a Muslim always he will show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one out of two. Even sabr or shukr. Clear? So the Prophet, peace be upon him, he was in a big ibtila'at, am I right, in his life. Is this a sign of hate? No, absolutely not. So if he put his beloved Rasul alayhi salatu salam under a test or ibtila, what about me and you? Basically, as I said, first of all, we don't ask Allah to put us in a test, but you have to ask Allah to give you the power and the strength to handle it, to ask Allah sabr and to ask Allah thabat. Because some ibtila'at, like Gaza community now, ibtila'at, it's not a joke, it's not easy, ikhwani. That's why their iman is a unique iman over there. While they are losing everything, or what you need more than the sabr, that you are seeing it and you are observing it, you are watching it in Gaza when the people are losing their own kids. And they raise their hand to God and they say, Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Take from our blood until you will be pleased with us. Who are those people? What kind of faith they have? How they can handle this crisis, this ibtila'at to that limit? The answer is Al-Iman. With Al-Iman, you will have Al-Imkan. With your Iman, with your faith, you will have the capability. We ask Allah to give them all the sabr that He created. Ya Rabbal Alameen. We ask Allah to heal them. We ask Allah to send His victory upon them and upon all the Muslims in Lebanon, in Sudan, in Syria, in Iraq, in India, in all the areas that we have these days, conflicts and ibtila'at and dhulm. And as I said in the past, this is the policy of this stage of our existence. It's not that Allah is not there or He's not exist or He's not helping. No, no, this is normal. And when you read the history, you will recognize that this is normal. Ayah number 18. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ. Imagine when the shaitan will take over your heart and your mind up to that limit, they decide not to give anybody from the a product of their garden with no exceptions. Sometimes you say, I will not give the, for example, the poor, but I will give the orphans. I will not give the men, but I will give the women. No, no, no. Their intention is what? No exceptions. Don't give anyone. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ. So what is the meaning of istithna, ya Hamza? Al-istithna, the exception. جَاءَ الطُّلَّابُ إِلَّا حَمْزَةً. Means the students are here except Hamza. So The exception here is Hamza. They made the yameen and the oath not to give any person with no exception. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ Subhanallah, ikhwani, there is no sign of love like this story, the sign of love in this story. In the same night that they had this pledge among themselves, the brothers, in the same night, Allah Azza wa Jal, He has sent a fire, a storm, tornado, and He flipped it upside down. فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ So, الطائف, the noun of طَافَ يَطُوفُ, فَهُوَ طَائِف. What's الطواف? الطواف, when you turn around something, like what we do in Hajj, we do طواف around the Kaaba. So, الطواف, number one, the meaning of طواف, you are turning around something, and you are repeating this, not just one time. Tawafa, one time, two times, up to seven times. So this ta'if, which is the fire according to the meanings, the fire came with a storm and it's turned around and within this garden all night from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah has commanded the fire to go and the storm to go. Just to that garden, if we have gardens in the area for the neighbors, nothing happened to those gardens. Just their land during the night while they were sleeping, because the intention is to go early in the morning before the poor and the needy will arrive to take their shares. They said we'll go early. So at night, what happened has been happened. Alert from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it was a big exam, big test to let you understand that if you are good, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا Remember this ayah. If you are good and you intend to be not good, sometimes Allah will not allow you to be not good. Sometimes Allah will help you indirectly to go back and return back and to let you see the haqq, haqq, and follow the haqq. And let you see the wrong, wrong, and be away from the wrong. This is ikhwani, blessing. This is a gift, special care from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the good people, to the believers, to the mu'mineen, that He will never allow them to be astray. He knows we are humans. He knows we are weak. He knows that we sometimes act as if we are not believers, but He is there for us. Absolutely, you need to give in the beginning to have at the end. You have to have a good relation with Him so He will give you this kind of help. Like if you have insurance or not, subhanAllah, just an example to understand. If you are not signing for a policy for the insurance and you have an accident, nobody will care. Nobody will cover. Nobody will come and help because you have no policy. You have no insurance. You have no relationship with any company. But if you have insurance, immediately they will come and they will take care and help you. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى تَعَرَّفُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الرَّخَاءِ يَتَعَرَّفُوا إِلَيْكُمْ فِي الشَّدَائِدِ Be good person with your Lord while you have no test. So He will come and help you when you have the test. But if you are not good with Him while you are good, while you are in a luxury life, easy, then when you have hardship, you want to go and knock at His door. Sometimes He will open, sometimes not. It's according to His knowledge and His wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ أصبحت means in the morning. The land, the garden, became in the morning. أصبحَ means, this is from أفعال الصيرورة in Arabic, means it turns to be in the morning. It's a flip to be. It became in the morning. كَالصَّرِيمِ What's الصَّرِيمِ? الصَّرِيمِ means when the night has no moon, no stars, very dark, severe dhalam. You can see even your finger. In the country areas, ikhwani, while there is no lights, if it's in the beginning or in the end of the month, while there is no moon, no stars, full dark, especially when you have gardens, trees, you can't see. So the garden in the morning before the sunrise, when they arrived over there, they saw nothing in it. It's all burned. It's all ash. It's all one color. The color of the burned things. فأصبحت كالصريم. Now they don't know what's going on. They still what sleeping. In the morning, فتنادوا مصبحين. You can imagine. They call each other. Hey, Abbas. Hey, Khalid. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. They start waking up each other because their intention to go early in this morning. And they just start calling each other. Let's go. We are late. They will come. We will find them in front of us. فأصبحت كالصريم فتنادوا مصبحين. They called each others أن اغدوا على حرثكم. Let's go in a hurry to our harth. What's the harth? The land that has fruit. Our wealth is over there waiting for us. So let's go in a hurry. أن اغدوا الغداء, leaving your house to your job or your destination in the morning. غدا. And the opposite is الرواح. When you go back home, this is الرواح. They left in the morning. على here, أن اغدوا على. This letter will give you the meaning of their intention to control على, over our land. Let's protect our land, our production, our fruit, our harvest, because they thought the poor and the needy and the other maybe organization, they are over there to take their money or take their right. It's not subhanAllah as when the iman will motivate you to share and to give and to return it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shukr and have the share of zakah as a duty to our community. We are part of the nation around you. That's why we said, let us help our brothers in Gaza and sisters over there by anything you can do for them. That's how the Muslim and the Muslims should be. مثل المؤمنين, the example of the mu'minin as the example of the one body of the person. If your finger gets hurt, if you are bleeding, all the body will have the fever and all the body will feel it. And that's why how we should be as one nation, insha'Allah ta'ala. فَتَنَادَوْ مُصْبِحِينَ أَنِ اغْدُوا عَلَىٰ حَرْثِكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَارِمِينَ. This is very obvious. If you are honest, if you are serious in your oath, if you still have the same intention of what we did last night, let's go. We should be there now. We are late. The one who said, إِن كُنْتُمْ صَارِمِينَ, maybe he found themselves a little bit late. They did not wake up early, so he says, are we still in the same intention? The plan is still active. In kuntum sarimin. فانطلقوا. Maybe they have the same ride with the same horses or the same camel. I'm not sure. Nobody knows the distance between their houses and the garden. But فانطلقوا means they left their houses. فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون. What's it تخافت? يتخافتون, the whispering between two or more in a very important matter. They are whispering, they are sharing the ideas, they are talking about the plan. For example, you have intention and you are in your way. You review the plan. Hey, Ahmed, you will take care of the gate. Hey, Khalid, make sure the back gate is closed. Hey, Samir, make sure when the merchant people arrive to let them enter from that door, not the front one, the back one. You make sure no animals allowed to be in the garden because we are collecting the fruit. You. So this is a takhafut. They are reviewing the plan. They are whispering and talking about the policy, about the intention, about the action, which one has to do the following. And this is normal. As a human being, we review sometimes in our way to do something, we review our policy. Sometimes you do this with yourself. You have this kind of conversation. I'll do this when I arrive to the office. I have to see this file. I have to start with checking my emails. I have meeting at 10 o'clock. I have to call the man or the woman to make sure they are coming. This is how we do التخافت. So, فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون. ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين. Make sure today none of the مساكين will come to take any share from our harvest. Make sure. So they were what? Serious now. ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين. وغدوا, they left, على حرد قادرين means They left. They are now on their way. الحرد preventing. وغدوا على حرد قادرين. قادرين in their thought means they have the قدرة, they have the power in their mind because they are the owners. If you are the owner, you can do whatever you want. You think you have the power to do whatever you want. المسلم only he will say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. It's not my حول. It's not my قوة. I can't move without the permission of God. I can't stand up without the permission of God. I can't say without the permission of God. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Those people, they thought, we have the power. We are the owners. We are strong. So we will apply our decision. وغدوا على حرد قادرين. فلما رأوها. They arrived to their garden and they saw, but they saw something different. It's not ours. This is burned. We have no gate, no fruit, no nothing. فلما رأوها قالوا. When they saw it, burned ash, no greens, no flowers, no fruits, no vegetables, no nothing. قالوا إنا لضالون. We might miss our exit. And absolutely, they're like act like crazy. They know they are in the right way, but they want to give an explanation. They want to give an answer. They want to give just something to let them understand what's happening. We might have a wrong exit, but this is our exit. We might have a different address. We just put something wrong in the GPS. Is this ours? فلما رأوها قالوا إنا لضالون. In the same moment that they were wondering if they miss their exit or their address or they have something in the GPS or, but they realize immediately, no, it's ours, but it's not there. It's ours, but look what happened. Immediately they woke up. They woke up as people with principles, people with faith. قالوا, no, it's not that we miss. قالوا, بل نحن محرومون. When they realized that it's ours, they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we had the pledge last night to prevent the fuqara from having 2.5% or portion of our product, He is preventing us from anything from our own garden. This is the situation of the disbelievers in the Day of Judgment. They will have nothing because they thought they have the power to do whatever they want, to reject the prophets and the messengers. And this is, by the way, indirect message to Meccan society. Look, we can take your blessing out. We can shut your city down. We can flood your economy. We can limitate your resources. It's all about the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's all belong to Him, everything in His hand. So they realize what's going on. And this is a sign of good, that they have a good heart. They're still not far away from the right and the straight path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بل نحن محرومون. We've been punished from Allah azza wa jal. This is also a good sign of iman and love. When you wake up immediately after you do the mistake in the same spot, that's also a sign of love from Allah. This is a blessing. This is a special care from Him. قَالَ أَوْسَطُهُمْ. Now, أَوْسَطُهُمْ in Arabic goes for more than one meaning. Please give me your attention. It could be the one that he is in the middle according to the age. If we have three, we have the youngest, we have the elders, we have the mid person, the one in between. This is one of the meanings. He's not the oldest one, he's not the youngest one, he's in the middle. Or it could be أوسطهم, the oldest one, because الواسط in Arabic is the biggest. That's why they call the column in the middle of the tent واسط البيت. واسط البيت. When you build a building, you put the biggest column in the middle of the building, not in the other side of the building, because this is the core, this is the center of the building. And وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا أمة كبيرة. Big nation by your values, your principles, your iman. Here, it could be also from the meanings of قال أوسطهم, the best among them regarding their relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more person with iman among them. قَالَ أَوْسَطُهُمْ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكُمْ لَوْلَا تُسَبِّحُونَ. This is an indication that this person, he has iman more than them, and he used to tell them maybe in the past, make istighfar, make tasbih. لَوْلَا here, like هَلَّا تُسَبِّحُونَ, means he realized we have a test from Allah, it's a punishment from him, what we have to do. One of them says, let's do tasbih. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, astaghfirullah, istighfar. And tasbih. That's how you react to your mistakes. Not to be stubborn and start yelling and screaming and shouting. No. Return to Allah. Do istighfar. Ya Rabbi, forgive me. Ya Rabbi, forgive me. Ya Rabbi, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. I did this by mistake. I'm not a bad person. I'm a Muslim. I love Allah and I love Rasulullah. I love my Iman. I love my Quran. I did it because I am, for example, I was weak. I was under pressure. But I am a good person, forgive me. I promise you not to do it again. قالوا, after he says, لولا تسبحون, قالوا سبحان ربنا إنا كنا ظالمين. So they realize all of them and they repent all of them. قالوا, not قال, all of them. سبحان ربنا, glorified to our Lord. سبحان ربنا, the owner of everything, the commander of everything, the one who can give us better than what we lost. He is giving us an alert to wake up after what we intend to do for this garden. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَ رَبِّنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. So this is, Ikhwani, a beautiful dua to teach your family members. When you do a mistake, ask Allah for forgiveness and say this ayah. سُبْحَانَ رَبِّنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. Ya Rabbi, forgive me and I admitted that I was wrong. I did wrong. I did dhulm. فَأَقْبَلَ, after they realize and they said, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. What is the dhulm that they did? Where is the dhulm? By preventing the fuqara from having the zakah. By not giving the fuqara the share that the dad used to give every season. This is dhulm. Because you are taking others' money. فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَلَاوَمُونَ. Now they start blaming each other, not to say that you are the one who did that or you are the one who did it. No. Their blaming is a positive blaming. Why you did not remind me? Why you did not just give me this ayah? Why you did not mention this to us? Why you did not mention it? Why you agree with... They start blaming each other. How they used to be blind when they intend to prevent the fuqara from their share in the rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's a good sunnah, to take a friend of you and to exchange with him the advices. One-to-one learning, one-to-one reminding, one-to-one dhikrullah. And taqoomu lillahi mathna wa furada. It's good to have a close friend to you to remind you and to review with him your iman, to review with him your way in this life. Ya akhi, show me if I am doing something wrong. How can I be better? Advise me. Tell me my weaknesses. Nobody is perfect. We all have weaknesses. Ask him that he is advising you with all the sincerity, without any kind of decoration. فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَلَاوَمُونَ. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا. Al-Muslim in general and the mu'min in general, even if he repent to Allah, he still have the worry and have the calculation in his mind. What about if Allah did not accept us? Ya waylana, we will be the losers. We will be in a big trouble if our tawbah got rejected. Ya waylana, inna kunna taghin. What we intend to go through, the way, the road that we started last night, it's road of hellfire, road of shaitan, way of losers, way of tughyan and dhulm. At-tughyan, ikhwani, to go over your limit. This is how the Muslims always, they not take it easy when they do a certain sin or a certain disobedience. Al-Muslim, he is very sensitive for his disobedience, for his bad deeds, for his dhunub. He will not let it go easy. He blames himself, he treats himself, he puts himself in a consequences punishment, a discipline orders punishment, or a certain schedule to do more nawafil, extra ta'a, extra salah, extra siyam, to at least forgive himself about how can I do that? How can I, as a Muslim, I'm praying Fajr every day in the masjid, how this could happen to me? We call this the ilm al-tazkiyah. He will go and put himself in session of refreshment in his iman. He will go to Umrah, for example, go to Hajj in that year, fast, for example, to 2 weeks or 3 weeks, donate, go serve in a certain area just to control his nafs or to punish his nafs sometimes. One of the scholars, he used to put himself in a grave, open grave, all night, just to give himself tarbiyah, to give his nafs tarbiyah. Imagine Al-Ghazali, what about us? So each one, he knows how to control his soul and to control his desire and to control his nafs, and how I can treat myself not to do this again, to wake up. We need to do that. قالوا يا ويلنا إنا كنا طاغين عسى ربنا أن يبدلنا or يبدلنا to قراءة. We ask Allah عز وجل to give us better than what he took from us. يا ربنا, they start making dua. يا ربنا, we realized our mistake. We are so sorry. We are now asking for forgiveness first, not to be mad from us second, and give us another chance. عسى ربنا أن يبدلنا خيرا منها, better than what he took from us, better than what we lost. We ask Allah to give the ummah better than what we lost as ummah. We ask Allah to give the Ghazan people better than what they lost in the dunya and in the akhirah. Ya Rabbi al-Alamin, we ask Allah for the Lebanese people to be in a good shape very quick. عسى ربنا. Allah is willing to give ikhwani, but he, as I said in the beginning, because he loves us, he loves his own slaves, he is willing to give them, but sometimes it will take time. Sometimes in the same spot, sometimes it will take time according to his wisdom and his knowledge. عسى ربنا أن يبدلنا خيرا منها إنا إلى ربنا راغبون. إنا إلى ربنا راغبون means we are now subject to go to Allah, worship Him, give on behalf of our faith, do more ta'a, do more ibadah, so He might accept our tawbah and He might return our land to us or better than what we lost, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allah gave them better than what they lost in that episode. كذلك العذاب. كذلك, O Meccan society, I'm here for you as we did with the people of the garden. العذاب to the kuffar of Mecca. العذاب to the people that they are oppressed, the Ghazan and the Muslims and everywhere. Allah, when He will allow عذاب to come, He will show no mercy. ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر. There is عذاب in the dunya for Meccan community or now for the Israelis that they are killing the Muslims everywhere. There is عذاب. It's coming. We don't know when and how, but it's coming. And there is also عذاب in the Akhirah. ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر. لو كانوا يعلمون. If they just realize that. If he allows things to happen, he has his own reason. He has his own wisdom. And when you pass the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you pass. You pass. كذلك العذاب والعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون. We will stop with this ayah. جزاكم الله خيرا for your time and your effort. And I'll open the session for the questions or presenting your homework from last class. The mic will go back to Brother Idris and Brother Usama. جزاكم الله خير. فيك يظهر عدلك طيب ريح عنبر فبفاتوك كنا نظهر بجنان فبعهده نفخر فأي عز